The Jabra Elite 85H's spec sheet promises amazing results. With up to 35 hours of noise-canceling performance, tri-digital assistant integration, smart listening modes, and Jabra's popular audio customization features, these headphones deliver a lot for the money. Thankfully, outside of some minor sound issues and imperfect noise cancellation, the Elite 85H lives up to the hype, making them a worthy Bose alternative and a notable addition to our best headphones and best noise-canceling headphone guides. And so I welcome you to today's episode of Home Gadgets, in which I'll make my honest review of the ANC wireless headphones, the Jabra Elite 85H. How does it look? Jabra spared no expense when crafting these cans. A combination of black mesh fabric, soft leatherette, and sturdy plastic compromises the frame. Woven fabric along the sides has nano coating to protect the circuitry from water damage. It hits that sweet spot between luxury and sporty. This makes the headphones ideal for all activities from travel to working out, though I don't recommend the latter. Another standout component is the curved yoke, which gives the Elite 85H an ultra-modern look, much like the AKG N700 NC. I appreciate the leather accents, but this material's scent becomes unsettling after 30 minutes of wear. Jabra bundles a number of accessories with these cans, including an auxiliary cable, USB charging cable, travel adapter, and a cheek leather carrying case to store everything. The headphones are available in 4 colors: black, navy, gold beige, and titanium black. What about the comfort? At 296 grams, the Elite 85H is an enormous ANC that outweighs competitors like the Bose QC35 second generation and the Sony WH-1000XM3. I felt fatigued sporting them after 2 hours. However, what it lacks in lightness, it makes up for comfort and fit. The ultra-soft foam ear cushions offer great padding. I liked how battery and plush the material felt on my skin. The oval cutout on each ear cup also gives plenty of room for ears to breathe. Stability is another strong characteristic, with the pre-tensioned headband conforming to your skull and providing flexibility to move around without applying unwanted pressure. Adjusting the extenders at the proper setting secures the headphones in place. Assuming control and preparation. Functionality is comprised of physical buttons and on-ear detection gestures. These two control schemes work well, although I was very impressed with the latter's accuracy. The cans automatically power on and enter pairing mode when folding out the ear cups, whereas swiveling them inward enables power off. You can also assign automatic play, pause, and answer mute call functions that execute when placing or removing the headphones on your head. The gestures worked flawlessly during testing. Jabra could have gone even more futuristic and placed touch controls on the ear cup panels like Sony's headphones, but incorporated a responsive free button scheme on the right panel that blends into the design. The two small protruding dots act as the volume, with one press, and navigation buttons when you hold them, while the intended circle in the middle is the multifunction button used to play, pause, music, or answer and end calls with one press. On the edge of each ear cup is a dedicated button, one for the active noise cancellation, hear-through mode on the left, and the other for the digital assistant mute mic function on the right. The aux and USB-C ports are at the bottom of the right ear cup. Pairing the headphones to an audio source is simple. Either swivel out the ear cups to initiate automatic pairing or hold the multifunction button for 2 to 3 seconds. Look for Jabra Elite 85 on the available devices list, select it, and you're good to go. It's all about the noise cancellation. Jabra introduces its smart active noise cancellation, which employs a 4-mic digital hybrid solution to clear out noise. How well does it work? Very effectively. The headphones are engineered to reduce a high amount of sound, just not as high as the QC35 second generation or the Sony WH-1000XM3. I tested the technology indoors and outside, and it performed well when pitted against different levels of sound. Most of the uproar in my apartment felt non-existent when sporting these cans. Jabra's technology does a commendable job with noise neutralization, but I found the ANC on the QC35 second generation performing better in public settings, with the WH-1000XM3 in a close second. In the streets, the Elite 85H muted about 70% of environmental fracas. It drowned out car engines and nearby conversations. Sirens and construction tools like jackhammers were audible, but at a moderate level. But raising it to the max level silenced completely these noises. The beauty of audio. The Elite 85H has 40mm custom-engineered speakers that exhibit a big, warm sound stage with plenty of sonic depth. It won't outperform the WH-1000XM3's headphones in the sound department, but it gives the QC35 second generation a run for its money. I tested several music genres and I was enamored by its sound reproduction. The hear-through mode. This isn't Jabra's first rodeo with ambient listening modes. Check out our Elite 65T review. The Elite 85H has the company's hear-through technology, which enables more environmental awareness without taking off the headphones. The mode comes in handy for eavesdropping on people's conversations or keeping tabs on conductor announcements when riding public transportation. Unfortunately, the mode distorts the bass and there's some audible hissing that goes in and out when media is paused. And what about the app? Much like the Elite 65T, the Jabra Sound Plus app for Android and iOS serves as the main hub for personalizing the headphones. It's programmed with four profiles: My Moment, Commuter, In Public, and In Private, to accommodate listening preferences when in a specific environment. You'll likely stick with My Mode since it's the first available option and shares the same settings as all the other profiles. Sound Plus has many features, none more useful than the customizable EQ that has 5 sound presets and the option to create or save your own sound profile. Surrounding Audio Mode lets you enable the listening modes directly through the app. The settings icon on the right brings up other features like the sleep mode timer, on-ear detection gestures, and special calling options. You can adjust the sound for callers as well as how much of your voice you want to hear. The discovery menu at the bottom hides a few others, including firmware updates, voice assistant access, and the Find My Jabra feature to locate misplaced headphones. Battery life. The headphones also work passively, meaning you can listen to them in wired mode for up to 41 hours. Bose promises up to 40 hours, while the WH-1000XM3 is rated at 38 hours. Even more clutch is the fast charging features that generates 5 hours of playback on a 15-minute charge. And what about the phone call quality? My only complaint is the Elite 85H requires you to speak loudly to be heard. My wife said that I sounded distant when speaking calmly in our quiet living room. I played with the side tone slider in the app to adjust how low or high my voice sounded on calls. What's up everyone, Home Gadgets is in the house, and now I'm testing the microphone quality of the Jabra Elite 85H. Please keep in mind, this bad boy has several microphones with the purpose of blocking out the surrounding noise, so my voice should be loud and clear to you. Now for some serious testing. Ice Ice Icicle, Pop Pop Popsicle, Test Test Testing, 1, 2, 3. Ice Ice Icicle, Pop Pop Popsicle, Test Test Testing, 1, 2, 3. Bluetooth connectivity. Wireless performance is top-notch. Bluetooth 5.0 provides up to 15 meters of cord-free listening. I was surprised that my connection held up well after chasing my dog outside the apartment and down a flight of stairs. More impressive was Jabra's multi-point technology, which connects the headphones with up to 8 devices simultaneously. I only paired 2, my smartphone and my tablet. Enjoying the perks of hearing Spotify on my phone while controlling the playback commands on my laptop keyboard. A conclusion. Despite these achievements, its few shortcomings don't warrant these headphones' Bose killer status. The Bose Quiet Comfort's 35-second generation is still better for ANC, and it's more convenient to carry around. While sonics on the Jabra Elite 85H are crisp and detailed, the Sony WH-1000X M3 have set the bar for sound quality on any ANC headphones, period. It also doesn't help that the Elite 85H's bass levels become distorted when enabling the listening modes. Overall, the Elite 85H is totally worth of your money and gives listeners more in functionality and performance than any other pair of headphones not manufactured by Bose or Sony, which speaks volumes. And so, in sum, for the pros, we have best battery life of any noise-canceling headphones, great sound reproduction, intuitive controls and listening modes, digital assistant support for Siri, Google Assistant and Alexa, companion app with personalized sound options, and strong build quality. On the downsides, the bass distorts and listening modes, and I think they are a little bit bulky and heavy. And this is it. I hope you've enjoyed the video. If so, please give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like something, please state it on the comments. And keep in mind, you've heard it best at Home Gadgets.